Hi everyone, Alfred here from Alfred.tv for yet another serious and granular review, unboxing, and whatever. Boy, it's hard to keep a straight face on this bullshit, really. Let me show you what I'm going to unbox and review in Alfred.tv style. By the way, .tv, what does it stand for? Is it like .tv for Transylvania? Transvestite or Tavavuvul something island that's sinking and then all the domains go away, whatever. Over to the product. And the product is the My Book Stud Edition also. Get it? Two? Alright, the My Book Studio Edition 2. And if we go down here a bit more, it says Performance for Creative Professionals. So, even before I unbox this freaking thing, I'm doomed to failure with the product because I certainly am not creative and I'm certainly not a professional at vomiting out these crappy YouTube videos and reviews that you all seem to like. I do it for you all. Oh boy, exciting stuff, right? Moving right along. And look at that. Look at that. They put a sticker, World's Best-Selling External Hard Drive, number one. World's best. So just like in that movie, Elf, we gotta like call their 800 number and say, congratulations! God, they put a freaking sticker on the box. Where are the statistics? Where are the metrics? Who made them number one? Let's look at the interface on this piece of crap. Okay, so it has FireWire 800 divided by 400, which equals 2. It has FireWire 2. Compared to FireWire 800, FireWire 2 sounds really slow. Let's see what else it got. It also has eSATA, and you know what I'm waiting for. I'm waiting for the eSATA N protocol, or the eSATAN protocol, because that's going to be really freaking hot in the market. And then it has Universal Seductive Bullshit, version 2.0, USB 2.0. And as far as the size of this drive, it's a 6 Terasaurus burger, the 6 TB, 6 terabytes, terabytes. But there's a caveat, all right? Let's take a look further at the box. On spinning the box around, we have ancient hieroglyphics and stuff written in Sanskrit, all right? And what it reveals is that this is indeed a RAID drive, and it's configured in two methods via software, you know, by pressing buttons. It's either RAID 0 striped or RAID 1 mirrored. So what that means really is while this is a 6 terabyte drive, notice it says dual drive storage system with RAID. It's actually 2 3 terabyte drives that are enclosed in this box, and you can either configure it as one big 6 terabyte FF class drive where it binds the two drives together in a RAID 0 or striped fashion, or it can be a very, very safe 3 terabyte external drive where the computer, when it writes to one drive, the internal controller in the drive will automatically write the information to the second drive. So the data is mirrored. So if one drive fails, your data is still intact. But, ergo, what's the conclusion in this scenario? If it's striped, RAID 0 striped, you get a bigger drive and a little bit more speed, but if one of those two drives failed, you're fucked, put it simply. Let's do another visual demonstration. This is an example of a mirrored RAID array. I really should have like a mirror there, but put in this configuration, the controller, when data is written to this drive, it also gets written here. Now, let's show you RAID 0 striped. It would be in this format. So now the two drives are bound together as one contiguous drive. The data is striped between the two, so it feeds through the controller a lot quicker. And if this is 3 terabytes and this is 3 terabytes in RAID 0, it's a 6 terabyte RAID 0, or what we call scary RAID. That's scary RAID, because again, if this drive fails, it takes the whole freaking volume down with it. Wow! And speaking about RAID arrays, specifically the word array, for those of you who perhaps are in a computer science class or advanced mathematics, where they're speaking about matrix mathematics or arrays, every time the teacher says array, make sure you clap your hands and go, array! Adam B. and I used to do that in class. We were stared at. Maybe one or two people laughed. That's about it. We did it for them. So there you have it. Raid Zero, Scary Raid or Striped. Raid 1, mirrored. 2 internal 3-terabyte drives in striped format. Raid Zero, it's 1 6-terabyte volume. And in mirrored, it's a redundant and safe 3-terabyte volume. In this particular situation, since I'm using it as a time machine, I really should put some reverb on that again. Let's do it again. Time machine volume. I'm actually going to keep it in FF class mode and keep it as a RAID 0 for 6 terabytes. I want a ton of storage out there. And this is the theory that, of course, the computer and the external drive is not going to fail concurrently. Let's open the freaking thing and whatever. So here you go. The unboxing of the Western Digital MyBook Studio Edition, also 2 6-terabyte, whatever, one-handed operation. You think of all the equipment I have here, all the crap I'd use a tripod. I say, nay, nay. The condom is now coming off. And hard to do with the arthritic left hand. There it is. And now the official one-handed Alfred.TV class unboxing. Whoop-de-freaking-do. There it is. Like, we really give a shit. All right, we're gonna have to use the electric slide method for one-handed dip, dip. All right, it's it's coming. And, Jesus Christ. You know, I do this crap for you all. And let's have it, like, do the drop test right out of the box. All right, there it is. Wow, that's a fat FF class drive. Yeah, there it is. So if you're not using this as a backup drive, if you have, like, if you're being, like, ballsy, if you got balls and you're using this as, like, a storage drive, but you're using it in Scary RAID 0, you know, striped format for the full storage amount, remember, that's double a failure rate. And yeah, the secondary condom. Is this stuff made in China? Like everything else on the planet? Someone look that up. And look, I'm banging the drive. I'm gonna freaking crash the heads. Yeah, look at the camera work on this. Look at the crap camera work on this video. So there it is. And it has a power button. It has the 2 FireWire 800s and the eSATA and the USB 2.0. And I guess there's a dongle in there for power. And there's the dongle. And let me tell you something about these powered dongles. You know, you better put stickers on them. I have like a gazillion of these things. You wind up not knowing what the hell product or machine it goes to. And you can really blow stuff out. Here you go with the official Alfred.TV label for the power supply. It is power for the Western Digital 6-terabyte RAID 0 external drive. The sticker has now been successfully deployed. Build quality, piece of shit plastic. What do you expect? I mean, not. I can kind of, like, look. It's kind of like a little loose on the side here. What did I get this from? Amazon? Yeah, whatever. So, I'm not impressed with the build quality. It's a hunkish piece of plastic, like everything else. And look at this. That's not good. This thing should be made of, like, titanium. Like, that really is not impressive. You know, maybe you can take the top off. Yeah, like, I'm gonna read the instructions. I guess you can, probably, to, maybe not. Who knows? Who cares? I plug the thing in, plug it into the time machine, and be done. By the way, in the cables, there's FireWire 800. There's also FireWire 800 to 400. And then USB 2.0, but there is no eSATA cable. Actually, that's how I plan to run this thing, as eSATA. So I gotta go rummage through all this crap and try to find a cable, whatever. Okay, so I scavenged an eSATA cable. And this drive is now hooked up to Octavius, the 8-core whore. I have a eSATA card. But look at this. What's wrong with this picture? All right, let me pan the camera back or unzoom it. All right,
Where did I put the 6 terabyte drive? It's on the ledge by the window. So, living in South Florida, when there's a hurricane and a breach, because I don't have effing hurricane windows in this condo, I got them at the one across the street, but not this one, all the data goes poof, poof. Because it's by the freaking window. Real smart. Moving right along. Octavia's boot up sequence. External 5 terabyte RAID array. Armed. SCSI tape drive. Armed. And we press a button and we wait for the bong. Give a bong to Steve Jobs. Where's the fucking bong? Oh well, okay, no bong, whatever. Maybe the speakers weren't on. Here we go. Here we go. What the hell were you expecting? Screen flow? Oh, it just bonged. Delayed bong. There you go. A bong for Steve Jobs. It just spit on the freaking camera. Yes, we are now, yeah, whatever. It's booting. I don't have a SSID. I don't have a solid state drive in this hunk of shit. Why? When they make a 1 terabyte solid state drive, or a SSID as I call it, then I'll get one. I got too much crap on this machine. To see my freaking dock, you need a magnifying glass to see it. Okay, Octavius is now booted. Look at my desktop pattern. Is this ergonomic or what? It really makes it very hard to see things on the screen. If you want a copy of this, like, you know, send me an email. It should be like the Alfred.tv standard desktop pattern wallpaper, whatever. All right, so there it is. The MyBook, look at this camera work with the camera shake as I swap hands. MyBook 6, wow, it's configured. It's configured in 6 terabyte FF class non-safe mode. Like, it's, I thought they would no, of course they're not gonna ship this as 3 terabyte mirrored. It's marked as a 6 terabyte drive. So there it is, FF class, and actually I think I have the software loaded in for another Western Digital shittle drive that I bought. Let's see, I guess I should install the software anyway. All right, I'm gonna install the software and press buttons, and let's see if it picks up the drive and gives me the option to configure it as mirrored RAID array. Hooray! Okay, so when I pop in the Western Digital CD, yeah, like you can read this. It has a folder called documentation. No, we're never gonna touch that. And then there's 3.dmg files, a WD plus Turbo installer, a WD Drive Manager installer, and a WD Anywhere Backup Mac dot whatever. All right, so I guess it comes with its own backup software. Very proud of it. I would assume WD Drive Manager would be the one that would give us the options for selecting the RAID type, though this WD plus Turbo installer does indeed intrigue me. I almost want to look at the documentation, but I say nay, nay. I say we randomly put in the WD Drive Manager installer, and let's see if we can screw up the other drives on this machine. I'm pressing buttons. Just for shits and giggles, I did open up the documentation, and I searched for the word turbo to see if there's any documentation with regards to those turbo drivers, and there was nothing in there. I did a little research on the web and basically said it changes the icon to put like a little speedometer next to it. It's supposed to be like enhanced drivers. A lot of people said no good, don't even install it, whatever. So I'm skipping the install on the WD plus turbo drivers. Don't do it! I'm gonna put in the WD Drive Manager though. Here we go. So even though the drive is in 6 terabyte, a scary RAID 0 striped format, I wanted to install the Drive Manager so I can just demonstrate, or at least show you the app of how you can configure the drive and whatnot, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, I'm going nuts. I install the Drive Manager. I don't see it, I don't find it, I don't know where it is. I'm looking in the application folder. I'm looking up in the menu. I see something flash WD for like a second and then it goes away. I turned the clock off. I turned off the clock because I thought it was running out of space. I don't know, whatever. The bottom line is I did open up the documentation. I did. I really did. And it says, note, WD Drive Manager does not work with the eSATA interface. Why? Why not? So if you're using it with a high-speed interface like eSATA, you can't use their device driver. It's just effing stupid. And what was on the CD-ROM with this relatively new drive. I think it was even out of date. There were newer drivers up on the website. So, I don't know. So far, it's getting a fail as far as setup. All right? So, if you're getting this, you're getting that drive, and you're using it eSATA, don't go nuts. The drive manager is not going to work. Anyway, I'm just going to use the Apple formatter to format this freaking thing, turn on Time Machine, let the machine sit and rot and back up. And then it's over. And it's done. And this crappy video is done. I'm going to press buttons. By the way, that WD Drive Manager software does have like a remove feature, so I can remove it, which I did. And I formatted it using Apple's utility. You know, disk utility. I pressed buttons. I called the 6 terabyte scary RAID 0 drive back to the future. That's not my Time Machine backup to back up all this crap, and this review is done. And here's the final Alfred.TV granular unboxing and review. It's 6 terabytes. It's very scary, and it's gray, and you can remove the cover. That's why it was a little weak, and it wouldn't be an Alfred.TV review without a comparison, so I'll compare it to this bag of Hewlett-Packard jelly beans. And the comparison is that you can eat these and you can't really eat that. And there it is, 6 terabytes by the window, waiting for a freaking hurricane to destroy everything. What the hell do you want? A serious review? I say nay nay. Alfred here from Alfred.TV signing off. Stay tuned, more to come. Let's see how many years it takes me to edit and upload this piece of crap. Maybe I'll surprise you again, it'll come quickly. Watson, come quick. That sounded dirty. Bye. I know you'd rather be playing with your iPhone right now.
I think I got Jimmy Hoffa on the line, I swear to God.
You might. Or it could be Rosie, you never know. Miles, what's the head count?
We got about 10 in there so far. And it's been 45 minutes.
And how many fish now? There was a bad joke somewhere in there.
Welcome to Alfred.TV.